In this video, I'm gonna show you how Regard made his brand new track called You. And if you've not heard of that yet, here is what that sounds like. What's going on, everyone? My name is Kling, and I help producers grow their music. And I really wanted to remake this track because I felt like there's a lot of really simple elements, but Regard is just such a talented producer, and his melodies and his chords and everything like that are just so nice, and he really gives it that old school vibe, but he really glues it together with a lot of newer type of sounds. So in this video, I'm going to show you how he made his new track, You, and also you can download the presets and samples and FLP down below in the description, so go check all that out, and let's dive into it. Once again, here is what the drop is sounding like. And one of my favorite things about this is the lead. But we'll talk about the lead first, because a lot of the other backing stuff is really important too. But we will go over the lead first. So let me just mute the lead, and here we go. And the lead is actually really simple. The processing of the lead is what makes it a really cool sound. Because if I take away all the effects on the lead, literally just a saw wave, which is really funny. It's really funny to listen back at that. But the sound itself, I just used a saw wave from, I'm in the process of creating a new pack. But either way, just a saw wave, one voice of unison, and that's really all that's here. There's no effects on here or anything. It's just a saw wave. And then this second one, in the song, I heard in the melody, that little low note stab was played by a different synth or different effects on it. So I just separated this one. It's pretty much the same thing, except I turned the filter on, and then I put the envelope like this, sustain all the way down, and just control that envelope with the cutoff. So if we remove that, actually I don't want to remove that because I didn't save these yet, but if you drag this onto the cutoff, it'll play like that. And I have the resonance up too, so it gives it that wow effect too, which is really cool. Just some distortion and a little bit of the phaser on here, about 43%. So once again, this is a really simple sound as well. Now this is where the main part of the sound comes from, is the processing, because the processing is what makes it sound really cool. And I love the effects on here too. So let me take all of these off. We'll go off on it one by one. So we'll start off with the EQ here, just cutting off the lows. And I felt like it was it wasn't a too bright of a lead, because it kind of blended in with the whole vibe of the track. It wasn't too bright. So just took off some of those highs. Then these are the most important things here, the phaser. This first preset is Mugit 2, and it gives it like a really cool vibrato effect because the feedback is at zero. So just listen. Like, that itself is giving it like this really old school type of vibe, because I mean, I feel like it's giving me like RC20 vibes, but it's like a cool vibrato, but it's really cool sound. After that, I have another phaser giving it more of like a normal phaser effect. Don't remember which preset this is, because I think it might be the default preset, I forget, but you can copy these if you'd like. And that's giving it that normal phaser effect that we all kind of know about. Next is an S1 stereo imager. This isn't doing anything too crazy. It's not really making it really wide. I use the rotation tool here, and if I were to just use like the FL pan, it just imbalances the sound to the right side. I feel like this rotation one really shifts the whole entire sound to the right. And then after that, I just have some simple delay and reverb. There's really nothing crazy going on here. Processing on that second lead is pretty much the same, but I just have a little boost here around 677. It's not necessary, but that's all those are. And then on the lead bus over here, I have the sidechain on 42%. It was really not pumping in the song because the song's really laid back. That is the whole entire lead. So now we can dive into the chords real quick. And these chords are pretty basic. I just have a sine wave, a saw, one octave down on both, probably not necessary, but it's what I did. And then five voices of unison, detune a little bit, four voices here, detune a little bit more. And then as the effects, I have a lot of effects going on here because I felt like I had to make this sound really old school. So hyperdimension, flanger, phaser, chorus, filter, and a MG low 12. But the main thing here is I'm using envelope 1 to control the resonance, the chorus, and the cutoff. So if I take that off, if I were to bypass this, just a saw wave, a standard sound, and I just put this onto the cutoff right here. And what I also did was I put a little bit of attack because it wasn't going super like attacky, punchy. It was more of that like slow. That can make a huge difference in the sound, and I really felt that in the original song. And then just rolling off some of the lows. Then after that, just some EQ, just a little bit of boosting here and there, nothing crazy, and reducing. Then I just have some EQ on here, or some reverb on here as well. As far as the second chord layer, there is just a little sound like this. And I felt like it added just a little bit on this hit right here. Like I felt like that was in the original, and I felt like that gives it a little bit of variation and some like power. I think it sounds really cool. But all this is a square wave and a bipolar harmonic wave, one octave down here. This is really nothing crazy. This is just what I just did messing around. The same effects here as well. So yeah, there's nothing too crazy going on this one. These aren't crazy sounds either. They're just basic sounds with the right layering and just like the right idea with. So now we can dive into the basses, and the basses are pretty basic once again. Once again, really cool sounds, but really old school sounds too. I like it. So this first layer is a deep bass subish layer, taking care of that low end. And here I just have six voices of unison, some detune, two octaves down, because I wanted to give it, because here, for example, if I have one voice of unison, we don't want that like really gritty sound. So we go for the detune sound. And then on this, I have a filter here, just getting rid of that really harsh high end. We don't want that. Then I also shape the envelope just like this, a little bit of attack like the chords I have. And then externally on this bass, I have a patcher here, doing the mono bass preset in the settings over here. Next, we have the more punchy layer. So this sounds really cool because it adds a lot of the, not high end, but just adds a lot of the punch that you can get in a lot of old school synths. And what I used here was a saw wave, just two octaves down, six voices of unison with a little bit of detune. Then I used this Monster 2 wave from the spectral setting, or wavetable section, sorry. One octave down here, and then these are all filtered with this low 12 filter here. What I did here was I dragged the envelope here, drug this onto the cutoff of here, and then to get more of the high end out, I used the filter over here as well. So pretty much doing the same thing twice. And then on the distortion up here, I have the envelope here, giving it some more grit there. And also, to make the bass a little more punchy, I took the envelope 2 here, put the sustain all the way down, put the decay down to 26 milliseconds, and then you drag this onto the coarse pitch rate over here. Do this for both, and then after that, hold shift, then option or alt, depending on what you're on, then click that. Gives it that initial punch. So if I bypass this real quick, and then post-processing on the bass, I just have a kickstart here at 87%. So really everything is inside of the synths here, so it's nothing too crazy. So here are the drums. Really basic drums. I sampled the kick from the extended mix and just some loops here. And as far as processing on the drums, I didn't even bust these together. So and then I just have a noise hit under that, and I think it sounds really good with the drums. And then is the creepy synth and the Atmos. So play together. I did a short on this, but I think this is a really cool point to talk about. Mm-hmm. And I added these dead last because I could barely hear these, but right when I found these, I was like, oh, these really glue together the overall song. So to make these, what you do is these are playing the chords of the song. And then after that, or what these are, it's just this mellow but unstable saw wave from this section. And then here, it's just a basic sound, one saw wave down or one octave down. I have the LFO controlling the fine pitch, giving that like vibrato effect just a little bit. And it's really low in volume too, so it's nothing to go crazy about. Then just some chorus and some EQ. So here for the Atmos preset, it's just a saw wave and then a sine wave. This is a really basic sound. Then as far as the effects goes, I just have some hyperdimension here, some chorus, reverb, and some EQ. So if I don't add these two sounds in, this is what the drop is sounding like. Sounds okay, but it's just sounding a little incomplete. But if we add these back in, and then on the master chain, I just have a Pro L2 giving it some loudness. That is it for this remake. If you guys enjoyed this one, please let me know down below. Once again, you can download the presets, samples, and FLP down below, all for free. You can check that out on my little shop website. And then if you guys want to see anything else, please let me know, because I love doing these remakes. They're really fun, mainly because I learn a lot, but you guys learn a lot too, because there's a lot to learn in just remakes in general. So if you guys want to see anything, let me know down below in the comment section. I'd love to hear. Oh no, my thing broke. Anyways, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. No. Ah.